What is going on, guys? Jack here, and welcome back to another Legends in Football Manager 2019. Today, we actually have a viewer vote. Yes, this was left open to my Patreon supporters. They were given three different goalkeepers to vote for. Who knows, the ones who didn't win may appear in future Legends in FM videos, but today we are going to be covering the Patreon pick, which is Peter Schmeichel. So here we have him at Gladsaxe Hero. I'm almost certainly pronouncing that wrong. They are a Danish club. They were in the third tier, I believe, at one point whilst he was playing for them. I will apologise for their horrific colour scheme because it makes this information at the top of the screen kind of difficult to read. So, yes, I apologise. But this club, they play in the lower leagues of Denmark. We've put him here. And, well, often with these databases, if you don't know, I get them off the Steam Workshop. There's a few creators who create Legends and FM databases. I tend to take those, twiddle the stats a little bit and the attributes for how I think the player should have been at the age they're at. Obviously, here we have Schmeichel, aged 17. Peter Schmeichel has a really weird career in that he didn't go to Manchester United from Bromby until 1997. And if I'm not mistaken, he wasn't even playing in Sweden and kind of playing professionally until he was like 23 or 24. So as a result, trying to guess how good he should be in terms of current ability at the age of 17 is just kind of impossible. So you can see here, he's got the potential to be the best goalkeeper in the world. I feel like certainly in contention as one of the best goalkeepers ever. I know someone's going to mention a few other players who should be in that list, Shilton, Yashin. I know there's other good goalkeepers, but I think Schmeichel's definitely in contention, certainly in terms of modern football, or more modern football. I guess you can't really call 15 years ago modern anymore. But yeah, you can see his attributes here. Obviously, he's 17 years young. He says his contract here expires in 1900. That's just because he's on a non-professional contract. Schmeichel, as I said, didn't sign a professional deal until I think he was 24. It was quite a long way along. He had a very late bloomer of a career. So it's going to be interesting here because he's got very good ability. Will he be able to match the potential that he's got? And who's going to find him first in Europe? It's going to be a bit of a gold rush to see who picks him up first because he's not got a professional deal at all. Bit different to the ones we did, obviously, with Pele and Maradona previously, which if you haven't seen, you can go check out. And, well, we'll see how he gets on, shall we? If you've got any predictions of how his career is going to get on, leave them down in the comments. I feel like the most interesting thing is going to be, can he displace his son, Kasper, in the Danish national team? And also, how far can he carry Denmark on the international scene? He was part of what some might argue was a somewhat golden age for Denmark in football. Let's see if he contributes to that in FM, shall we? Anyway, we're going to go forward, I think, 2 years to begin with. We'll see if he gets a big move to Europe. I expect him to. Obviously, it could be a bit interesting. Goalkeepers in FM, they never really have standout performances, but this is Peter Schmeichel we're talking about. He has potential. He has current ability, as you can see. Can he show it on the world stage? Let's find out. Okay, guys, so we have gone forward just 2 years, and as you can see here, Peter Schmeichel has been picked up by Bayern Munich. Yes, I don't know if I should be surprised or not. Obviously, because we're playing in modern football, things play out differently. Scouting is better, so I can somewhat believe that a talent like Peter Schmeichel would have been picked up sooner than he was, obviously, in his actual career back in the 80s. But yes, he's been picked up, as you can see here, by Bayern. He's actually made two appearances already for the national team. Let's have a look at that first. Kasper Schmeichel is listed as vice-captain. But as you can see here, Peter actually in the team ahead of Kasper, who is 33. I kind of forgot how old Kasper Schmeichel is. It's a little bit scary to think about it, isn't it? You can see here, he was signed for £5 million and well, to the Russian team Krasnodar. And he's been playing pretty well for them. But unfortunately for him, his dad's just doing that a little bit better. How about we compare the two? I mean, you can see there, I think Kasper is probably the better player. I'd want to take it back. Actually, Peter is the better player. I was going to say Kasper's the better player. I feel like the polygon looks deceiving. I guess it depends on how much you value the physicals and the mental aspects of a goalkeeper, but Peter's better. I'm sorry, Kasper. You've been outdone by your dad a lot sooner than I thought. But yeah, Peter Schmeichel, signed, as you can see, by Bayern. And, well, let's see. How long did it take? So it looks like he played 19 games for Gladsaxe. In that time, he kept 10 clean sheets, which is pretty impressive. Of course, playing way down in the lower leagues of Denmark, that was going to happen. And, yeah, Bayern picked him up on a free transfer. So I guess this was in January, if I had to guess. We can probably take a look. If we look at Bayern's transfer history here, yeah, they picked him up in January as a free transfer. So that's interesting. And they actually gave him 7 games, and he's played 3 games the most recent season. So what happened to Neuer? Did Neuer pick up injuries? I guess that's the first thing to check here. Definitely not a fixture kind of the regularly of the main team just yet and of the first team. So we've got Neuer here. Have you had injuries? It looks like you have. Yeah, you can see here, torn wrist ligaments, and he also twisted his ankle. So a few opportunities, I think, given to Peter there. Let's have a look. So that was the 19th of the 2nd, 2019. If we just look at the fixtures for that date, the 19th of the 2nd, 2019, where are we? Is it around here? Yeah, so Peter Schmeichel came in. How did you do, Peter? So you got a 6.3 against Hertha Berlin, against Gladbach a 6.4. PSG in the Champions League knockout round, a 6.7. Only shipped one, which I guess is okay. Unfortunately, with that loss, they did get knocked out the Champions League there. Against Wolfsburg, he got an 8.0, so a bit of a man-of-the-match performance there, maybe, or certainly close. Against Mainz, 6.8. Freiburg, he was back out of the team. So he might have had a few other appearances here and there, but he did okay in his first run in the first team. If we just compare him to Neuer real quick, you can see Neuer, obviously one of the world's best footballers. Schmeichel has potential to be very close in terms of quality to Neuer in his prime. In fact, I think he's just has the potential to be a little bit better in this database, which of course you can download below. But he hasn't quite broken through yet. I'll be honest, in some ways I'm a little bit disappointed he's gone to Bayern. I was hoping he might go to a smaller club and slowly, you know, make his way through Scandinavia and then maybe break into Europe. If we look at the leagues I had loaded here, you can see I did load Denmark, Norway, Sweden, Holland, just on the off chance he moved to a smaller league. No disrespect to Holland and the Netherlands. I don't mean to put you in the smaller league bracket, but, you know, I didn't expect him to go necessarily straight to the Bundesliga or the Premier League, for example. So I gave him some opportunities. It hasn't happened here, unfortunately. It's going to be interesting now to see how patient he is around Neuer and how quickly Neuer falls off. In terms of the Bundesliga, if we just look at it here, Bayern have won it the last 2 seasons. They actually won it on goal difference by 1 goal. Wow. Okay, how tight was this? They had the exact same record and 1 goal was the difference. I want to see how close this was in terms of goal difference. Oh my gosh, look at that. What is the sorting rules in the Bundesliga? So it goes to goals difference, then goals scored. So literally, if Dortmund had scored 1 more goal all season, or Bayern had conceded 1 more, they would have lost and Dortmund would have won the league. That's crazy. So, I mean, did Schmeichel play well this year? I didn't actually check his average rating. So he got a 6.2. He only played 3 games. He did keep a clean sheet in those games. I mean, that's all I'm going to say on the matter. So maybe he contributed a little bit. I want to look at his form here. So how did he get on? He actually came on as a sub against Augsburg. And he didn't concede in that game. So that was one of his clean sheets. You can see, actually, besides that, he hasn't played in the last 20 games, unfortunately, but unused sub a lot of the time. So he is second choice keeper, just not getting given a whole host of, appearances. What about if we look at Bundesliga only? Yeah, you can see it. We can only look at the last 20 games. Has he been playing in other competitions? It looks like he might well have been playing non-competitive games, I guess, for the B team, but that's not so interesting, is it? Let's be honest. Anyway, I think we'll go forward another 3 years. We'll see how he's getting on in the first team, see how Bayern are getting on. We'll be interested to see, has he surpassed Neuer, or is he still playing second fiddle? Don't go anywhere. We'll be back in just a second. Okay, guys, so we are back again. 2023, Peter Schmeichel, aged 22. Let me remind you, he was still non-professional at this point in his actual career. Here, on the other hand, 31 appearances for the national team. You can see here, his overall ability has improved incredibly. I feel like his aerial reach was 11 5 years ago. It's now up to 16. There is a lot of yellow appearing here. And he is winning a fair bit at Bayern. Let's have a look here. So he played 32 games this season. Actually, looks like it was last season that he broke into the main team and became the first choice goalkeeper here at Bayern. The season before that, to be fair, 18 appearances, so he made a decent amount. Did they sell Neuer, or did Neuer retire, or what happened? Let's see, is he still in the team, Neuer? He's not. Huh. Tell you what, let's have a look at the transfer history. He can't have retired, I don't think. That would be very soon for him to retire. I'm imagining it's halfway through this season that he was let go. Where are you, Neuer? Did he just retire? I mean, I guess we're going to have a look. Neuer, where are you? You're a free agent. Interesting. So he literally just got replaced halfway through a season. He was on a 7.24 and they just decided, nope, You're not good enough anymore. And since then, he's been a free agent. I mean, when you compare the players now, you'd have to say Peter is just the better player. Perhaps not in terms of distribution, but everything else about him. You know, perhaps not the most modern type of goalkeepers, but physically significantly better. Aerial reach, communication he has been. Obviously, Neuer being 37 is going to have started to, you know, devalue as a player and just kind of lose his ability. It's worth noting, actually, with Peter Schmeichel, valued at 52 million on 215 grand a week and 3 years left on his current contract. Let's just have a quick look at the Danish national team. What have they been achieving? So they're in the Euro qualifiers at the moment. Last year was the Qatar World Cup. How did they get on? World Cup qualifiers. It looks like they didn't qualify for the World Cup, unfortunately. And now I've broken the screen somehow. How have I managed that? I mean, the screen is literally broken. I've gone into the future on the fixtures and it doesn't like me. But yes, unfortunately, they couldn't qualify for the World Cup, which is a bit of a shame. You can see he is listed as their key player. In the world rankings, Denmark 21st. You can see they were as high as 9th, so they were doing really, really well. That is really going to have hurt them, the fact they didn't even qualify for the World Cup. I don't know if we can have much of a look at how the World Cup actually went. So the holders are Belgium. But yeah, I don't think Denmark qualified at all, which is... Is that a shock? I guess it's not the biggest shock in the world, is it? But I don't know, with Peter Schmeichel playing, you would have thought they'd make it, especially with the larger format, of course, where there's way more teams qualifying. Yeah, I can't see them here. So they didn't qualify despite being ranked very highly in the world rankings. In terms of Bayern, let's have a look at Bayern and what they've been doing. It looks like they've won a lot of games in a row here. Oh my gosh. That's a lot of green and very little red. It looks like they might have lost the Champions League final. Let's have a look. So Bundesliga. Wow. Okay, so Leverkusen actually won it last year. So Bayern outdoing Bayern, as you can see there. However, this year, Bayern have gone absolutely nuts. They've lost 4 games all year, 88 points. What happened the season before? So the previous season was the season where it was the first one where Peter was the first choice keeper for the second half of it. It looks like they did awfully. Wow, that is seriously shocking in terms of what's been witnessed there. Obviously, that's the most recent season. But yeah, they finished down in 4th. So did they not even get Champions League football that year, or did they get it through other means? I've actually managed to completely break the schedule page. This is actually an achievement. Right, I'm going to try and fix this. I'll be back in a second. Okay, guys, so I've managed to fix things. I don't know exactly what happened. I think I might have broken it. Then in frustration, I dragged this bar over to the right and I broke my custom skin. But we're back now. I have fixed it. Tech support with Jack. I mean, let me tell you now, it's a good job I didn't try and fix it whilst commentating it all, because it took like 5 minutes to work out exactly what was wrong. But yes, you can see here, 2020-21. So this was the first season when Neuer broke into the team. They lost in the Champions League first knockout round on penalties to Juventus. It looks like here Neuer was actually still playing. Did Neuer get injured then? I thought he might have been dropped halfway through, but it might be a case of that he just had loads of injuries. Yeah, you see here actually he broke his hand. He pulled his groin before that. It looks like he got a series of injuries and maybe they were just alternating him and Schmeichel around. It might also be a case of that Schmeichel was performing so well that they wanted to play him kind of more often. But anyway, yeah, 2021-22, the Champions League, how did they get on? They got to the quarterfinals and lost. So not great there. They also lost in the DFB Pokal semi-finals. And then in this most recent year, how did they get on? They're in the Europa League, and they actually lost in the Europa League final because of that poor league position. They didn't get Champions League football, I guess. You can see they lost to Arsenal in the final. Peter, 6.7. Didn't have one of his best games. I feel like Peter Schmeichel was a player known for turning up on the big occasion, but that just simply hasn't happened here so far, which I don't know how to feel about. Should I be surprised? It also looks like in the DFB Pokal, they struggled again. Of course, this is the major German domestic cup. And in fact, in the last 3 years, Bayern haven't been able to win it. So despite reasonable success, you'd say, in terms of their kind of league wins, they've not achieved a massive amount. We'll just have a quick look at landmarks here for Peter Schmeichel. So you can see here, he was players runner-up and footballer of the year runner-up for the Bayer kind of Bundesliga team. I guess this was the club relative stuff. I'm just looking to see if there's anything major he got here in terms of landmarks. You can see all the trophies he's won here. So he has won trophies so far, but hasn't been kind of super standout. I don't feel like he's achieved as much as you might expect him to have achieved, although perhaps that's a tad unfair. He has only in the last couple of years passed Neuer and become the first choice goalkeeper for Bayern, and while he's still got, what, another, well, 3 years left on his career, and, well, way over 10 years, you'd imagine, left of his career. You can see some of the awards he's won here. German Players Player of the Year, runner-up. That's pretty impressive. I feel like in Football Manager terms, generally speaking, just goalkeepers don't perform that well. So actually a 7.55 average rating this year with 16 assists is a pretty good achievement. So maybe I'm not cutting him enough slack. I'd be interested to know what you make of his performances so far. We'll have to see how he gets on, obviously, in the next episode with the latter stages of his career. I'm going to be curious to see if he stays at Bayern throughout or if he moves on. Of course, he was known for being a fairly loyal player, you know, had relatively long stints at clubs. Modern football, there's a lot more money around, although to be fair, he's been offered a lot of money, and playing for Bayern, there's not really that many places you could go to further your career. So it seems like, well, if you ask me, he'd be a natural replacement for Neuer long term in this alternate Football Manager universe. But anyway, guys, that's going to wrap up everything from me today. Apologies for the tech issues. Apologies also for the gap since the last Legends in FM video, which was Diego Maradona, which you can find over on the channel. And, well, hopefully I see you guys for a part two of Peter Schmeichel in Football Manager 2019. Leave a like if you've enjoyed. If you've got a legend suggestion for a future video, please leave it down in the comments. And other than that, it is me, Jack, and I will talk to you guys in a bit. I'm out.